Station. This is Houston. Are you ready for the event?
This is the International Space Station. I hear you loud and clear, and welcome.
I like to dance. Can you dance in the ISS in space?
Hi, Tracy. I think it would be fun to have more dancing up here. We do a little bit of it. We do play music up here. So I will demonstrate something that's not exactly a dance, but it kind of looks like it. And this is a way that you can demonstrate angular momentum. It's the way a cat turns. If you ever wonder how a cat can always land on its feet, this is how it does it. Excuse me.
So that's some serious hip shaking going on.
Hi, my name is Preston Thompson, and I go to the I Promise School in Akron, Ohio. I have questions about sleeping routines, like where do you guys sleep and how gravity works when you sleep?
Hey, Preston. So where we sleep is actually in the floor, the walls, and the ceiling. So actually behind me, our crewmate Matthias, our German astronaut, that's his crew quarters. And so there's one here, and there's four in another module, and Tom's going to show you. Basically, he's just going to go into what looks like the ceiling, but up here, you can't tell it's a ceiling or not. And inside there is about the size of a sleeping bag and a computer, and that's what we use it for, is to sleep, and then also to be able to do things like get work done in the evenings and correspond with people at home. In terms of how gravity works in your sleep, it's kind of the same as it does during the day, so you would tend to float around. Different people like to do different things when they sleep. Some people like to be restrained and to feel very wrapped up. Some people like to float around. One thing that takes your brain some time to get used to is when you're in space the first few days, you always feel like you're falling. So as soon as you close your eyes, you get the sensation that you're still moving and still falling forward. So it's really hard to fall asleep at first because your brain just doesn't want to go to sleep when it feels like it's falling down. So it takes a few days for your brain to adjust to that to be able to sleep normally. But once that happens, it's just personal preference on how tightly you want to be held by, we use bungee cords to hold us down. And it just depends on how tight you want to be held down while you're sleeping.
If you had to live on the space station for the rest of your life, what three items would you take with you?
Hi, Marty. Boy, that's a tough question to answer. However, I assume you mean I can't bring my family. Now, they might not want to come live with me for the rest of our lives on the space station, but if I couldn't bring my family, I would probably bring, you know, we have so much stuff for, that's wonderful here with science. I would bring things like probably a paint set. I would bring a library, whether that's a Kindle, with all the greatest literature that I could find. I'd have a lot of time to read. That'd be good. And I'd probably bring a musical instrument to let my creative side grow. So that would probably be it.